Back out here at Collins Moreland Arena, Chris Collins, Todd Howe, our studio producer is Dave Reno. The Greenfield Green Wave continue their winning ways. They've now won 5 of 6. Another shutout for Riley Drew. They beat the South Hadley Tigers by a count of 4-0. And I'll tell you, Todd Howe, you're not going to find many games played better than this one for Greenfield.
No, Greenfield played well, and South Hadley's no slouch, right? I'd say they're one of the top 4 or 5 teams in Division 3A in Western Mass. They played solid, but Greenfield's controlling the puck outside the play. South Hadley, if you were to count how many minutes they actually had control of the puck, it weren't that many.
They went. Greenfield went 2 for 7 on the power play. The first two goals in the first period, O'Sullivan with a goal. Also, Barnes with a goal on the tip-in from the McGoldrick shot. And then two goals in the third period. Shane Pruzak lit the lamp, as did Sammy Knight with that backhander on the feed from Mike McGoldrick. So a solid performance. Riley Drew did a good job in the net, but the shots on goal tell the tale. I mean, the game was played most of the night in the South Hadley end of the building.
Yeah, Greenfield outshot South Hadley the third period 14-6. They had the shot advantage every period. They played strong, and what I'm most impressed with, it was a balanced attack, all three lines. He's rotating three lines, which is what you need. When you come down to playoff time, if you've got a close game and you're going to overtime, you need those three lines. You can't rely on two lines. You're just going to win them out.
Depth is important in any aspect of any kind of sport, but especially in hockey. If you've got three functioning lines and you've got two or three sets of defense that you can interchange. I mean, not only was he double shifting and changing the line combinations, he also was switching out his defensive pairing. Sometimes he'd put Harris out there with Bryant. Sometimes he'd put McGoldrick out there, you know, with two or three other partners. It's good to be able to have those options. And clearly Greenfield has those options right now.
And they weren't trying hard to match up. It wasn't like he said, oh, wait, there's a weaker line out there. Let's put the third line out there. No, he put the third line out there whenever he wanted to.
Absolutely. So Greenfield notches their 10th win of the season, and we are back in this building a week from tonight as Chicopee Comp comes to town. We'll be on the air, I believe, with the pregame show right around 6:25, unless they change the time of that game as well, like they did with this one. But a big win for Greenfield. It was a lot of fun, a great game to watch. And by the way, if you didn't get a chance to hear this game or watch it, you'll be able to watch it on YouTube coming up in the next couple of days, courtesy of the FCAT media page at YouTube.com. FCAT's Kevin Murphy is here filming a simulcast, and you'll be able to hear our call and watch the game on YouTube, again, within about 48 hours from this broadcast. But Greenfield wins 4-0 over South Hadley. For my broadcast partner, Todd Howard, studio producer Dave Reno, thanks for listening and thanks for watching Hockey Night in Greenfield.